Recently, Samsung is under a lot of fire as users are fed up with annoying and unwanted ads in One UI. XDA TV host and writer on XDA developer, Max Weinbach wrote an article about all the places these ads pop up on Samsung Galaxy phones. Since then, more and more users have taken to Twitter and other tech forums to convey their discontent about Samsung showing ads on their devices. And in our today's video, we are going to explore why smartphone manufacturers are trying to show more and more ads on their phones. Hey everyone, I'm Chaser and welcome to another TechSquare video. The real and only reason smartphone manufacturers put ads on their devices is to have more profit. Smartphone manufacturers aren't making as much profit as they did before selling their devices. The total smartphone market has grown over 3.2 billion over the last couple of years. But recently, the overall market has seen a stalled growth. In 2010, the smartphone manufacturers shipped over 300 million smartphones, and in 2019, the number is around 1.3 billion. However, from 2014 to 2018, the total number of smartphones shipped was over 1.4 billion. This means the number of smartphones shipped worldwide has decreased. As an increasing number of users have a smartphone on their hands, they simply don't feel like need to upgrade their phones every year. While the number of new users buying new smartphones is also at a standstill due to economic and various other reasons. So, smartphones are not selling as much as before. Meanwhile, over the last decade, there are so many smartphone manufacturers have entered the market. Thus, competition has become much more intense than before. Manufacturers have to spend more money on promotional and marketing efforts to sell a smartphone than ever before. While the cost of manufacturing is also on the rise, companies are required to spend a lot of money on research and development as well. Companies that rely on others for components have to spend more on the hardware. The cost of labor has also increased over the years. All these accumulated costs have resulted in an increased price of smartphones. On the other hand, Chinese manufacturers are offering smartphones at an aggressively competitive price point that big manufacturers like Samsung and Apple have almost lost the middle-income market. As the market is saturated and companies have to spend more on making and selling a phone, selling smartphones is no more profitable except for Apple. But they have several competitive edges that others don't. That's the topic for another video. On the other hand, making chips and components for other manufacturers is more profitable for Samsung than selling their own products. Anyways, since phone manufacturers can't make profits from selling their phones, they're looking for other ways to make their profit. And one of the ways is by showing ads. The Chinese smartphone manufacturer Xiaomi makes very little revenue from selling their phones at nearly cost or even without any profit. But they do this by choice. Their whole value proposition is to offer smartphones at a comparatively lower price. How do they are able to achieve that? Well, for starters, they don't spend billions of dollars in advertising and marketing efforts. Instead, all communication is done through social media. They also did not spend a fortune in opening up stores worldwide and sells their phones directly to the consumers through online. It also allowed them to cut out the middleman and further lower the prices of their smartphones. And then, Xiaomi keeps its profit margin from hardware sales under 5%. Cause Xiaomi doesn't consider itself an OEM, rather in its IP offering, they claim themselves as an internet company. Which means their primary focus is not making a profit from selling the devices, but from the internet services that they provide. Xiaomi's internet service includes music, cloud, app store services. Serving users with ads are also included in their internet service. They show you ads through notifications, inside their apps or on the App Store, lock screen and so on. Since they are selling you the product at a lower price at the same premise that they will show you ads, it's somewhat acceptable by the users of Xiaomi. Xiaomi isn't the only Chinese manufacturer doing this. Another Chinese brand, Realme, which frankly just copied Xiaomi's business model, including its naming scheme. Rumors are, Realme is also testing out ads on their newly rolled out Realme UI. Well, Apple does this too. But the practice isn't limited to Chinese manufacturers only. Apple also shows ads to sell their subscription services like iCloud, Music, TV Plus, and so on. They currently have 6 subscription plans for their consumers, and through ads, they are trying to sell those plans to more and more users. Now, you might be wondering why would Apple out of all the companies show ads on their phones, when they are already making so much profit selling those devices? Well, you guessed it right. money. Selling subscription means you need to convince your customers once instead of every year. Provided that you don't screw up, you got yourself a solid income. However, Apple themselves does not show any third-party ads on their device. And the ads about their services do add value to their customers. And Apple tries to blend in these ads to their UI elements as much as possible that most users are not bothered by it. Anyways, Samsung shows ads on their smartphones as well. Previously, Samsung used to give us push notification ads for new products from Bixby, Samsung Pay, and Samsung Push service. And most users are not even bothered by this. However, things got outrageous when they started to show third-party ads on their apps. Like in a tweet by Todd Hasselton of CNBC, we can see Samsung had put an ad from DirecTV in their stock dialer app. Samsung Music has ads that look like another track in your library and will give you a pop-up ad for Sirius XM. Similar ad exists throughout a bunch of other Samsung apps, which has made people outrageous. Samsung charges premium prices for their phones. For a premium device to ads like this is frustrating. But as I've mentioned at the beginning of my video, that the growth of the smartphone market is at a stalemate and the cost of manufacturing and selling a smartphone has gone up due to intense competition. Selling a smartphone isn't as profitable as it was 5 years ago. But as I've mentioned at the beginning of my video, that the growth of the smartphone market is at a stalemate and the cost of manufacturing and selling a smartphone has gone up due to intense competition. Selling a smartphone isn't as profitable as it was 5 years ago. However, for Samsung to make money this way while keeping their premium price tag is not acceptable. Now, I understand Samsung trying to make extra profit, but they should ensure that through other alternatives. For example, they could only show third-party ads to their more affordable phone series. They could also bring few subscription-based services for their users, similar to what Apple does. Although Samsung quietly launched a subscription plan for the S20 series phones called Samsung Access. Under Samsung Access program, they're allowing buyers to purchase flagship phones for lower monthly fees. Access also includes a subscription to Microsoft 365 complete with 1TB OneDrive for cloud storage and premium care protection. Although Samsung Access is for S20 variants only and could extend to Note 20 phones and only limited to their flagship lineup, but for premium devices, Samsung should bring more subscription-based plans like this instead of putting third-party apps to their premium devices. They could also bring more premium phones like the Galaxy Z Flip and Fold. But more importantly, Samsung must not put invasive ads on their phones. Anyway, that's all with our video for today. If you like this video, then hit the like and share with your friends. Comment below to let us know your thoughts. Consider subscribing to our channel for more videos like this and press the bell icon to get notified for our future videos.